In war, there are visible wounds and some that are hidden. Gaza, the coastal enclave bound by the blockades from the sea and on the ground, is also facing an explosive mental health crisis, according to doctors and non-governmental organizations. Dr. Yasser Habujameh heads the Gaza Community Mental Health Center. The NGO treats patients in multiple Palestinian cities in the Gaza Strip.
We feel like, you know, being abandoned from the international community because it's not the hottest issue on the news.
Trauma, severe depression, suicide, untreated post-traumatic stress disorder, and even children unable to utter simple words are among the afflictions doctors face daily. Physical and psychological health in Gaza is in danger, according to these experts who held a congressional briefing in Washington. Gaza's mental health problem reaches every class, whether the patients have the means for treatment or not. Adding to the despair some Gazans feel are the deep cuts to the United Nations Relief and Works Agency for Palestinian Refugees, or UNRWA. The agency runs education, healthcare, and assistance programs in Gaza. President Trump recently announced that the United States would no longer fund UNRWA, saying the agency needs to make unspecified reforms and calling on the Palestinians to renew peace talks. To make up for the $350 million in cuts by the U.S., the European Union and Gulf countries have increased their UNRWA funding, most notably Saudi Arabia, who this week pledged $50 million to the agency.
We had to scramble and figure out how we were going to overcome the largest financial deficit our agency has ever faced in its history. We've succeeded in bringing our deficit from $446 million down to, today, $21 million.
Brian Barber has been traveling to Gaza for the last 25 years. He says,
the most injurious form of exposure to political violence is not those dramatic events that I just outlined, but it's the humiliation that Yasser was talking about before. This sense of, from the very first day in Gaza, I hear people refer to themselves as subhuman.
A ray of hope or relief may come in the Trump administration's long-awaited peace plan set to be unveiled in early 2019. But Dr. Habujameh is in Washington now to sound the alarm.
The lack of imminent solution increased the feeling of hopelessness.
Munir Al-Hamoud, I-24 News, Washington.